I would not like to play first, though. Alright, this is a very good hand, I think. I mean, it's a little land light, but... Oh. Yeah, I'm very smart. I have a Doomblade in my deck still. yeah. I just took the Enforced Mulligan, plus I'm going to draw a Swamp and not gain life off my staff. Well, it's one of my finest moments, I must say. Alright, opponent kept. I'm not mulling, even though this is basically a 6-card hand because of the Doomblade. First of all, my opponent could play an artifact creature. There's that. Yeah, even drew the Swamp. Secondly, I've got a, you know, a decent hand of Essence Scatter, Sensory Deprivation, Disperse, all those things are fairly good. Gnawing Zombie. Alright. Time for a Dark Prophecy, I suppose. Let's see what my opponent's up to this game. I mean, Gnawing Zombie's alright, but not a huge clock on its own. Alright. Divination's nice. I can even discard the Doomblade. I suppose I could have played the Swamp there to Doomblade a Sliver Construct or something this turn. Suspect that will not be coming up. So what am I Essence Scattering? I would not mind Essence Scattering a Life Bane Zombie this turn. I probably would Essence Scatter a Corpse Hauler, especially since I do want to cast Divination without discarding. I mean, even though I can discard Doomblade, I would rather just discard nothing. So I'll let my opponent dictate what happens here. I'm just going to take my one, though, since it is not going to warrant a Disperse quite yet. And obviously casting Sensory Deprivation on Gnawing Zombie is not too strong either. I suppose a Lifebane Zombie I could just Sensory Deprive, but I think Essence Scattering it is still pretty good. Dark Prophecy, yeah, that I can't do anything about. Ooh, Staff. Well, once again, I think just playing Staff first is solid. Because I have Sensory Deprivation and Disperse, I'm not too worried about my opponent's plays this turn, and I would rather Essence Scatter Nightwing Shades. Right, on 3 mana. Ooh, Phantom Warrior. Alright, that actually seems better than Divination as well. Would like to start clocking my opponent. Hopefully this doesn't get Doombladed. I'm gonna take... Well, I'm not gonna take my 3 here. I'm gonna block the Gnawing Zombie. There aren't too many cards that punish me. Yeah, Ring Flesh does, but... Alright, Cursed Spirit. That looks like a good Sensory Deprivation target. Hello. And I'd rather, I think, keep up Essence Scatter at that point. Alright, since Sorely Deprive is the Accursed Spirit, hit for 2. This keeps up Essence Scatter. I could also cast Disperse if I really needed to. I think I'm just going to be taking 3, Essence Scattering a Nightwing Shade, and then on my turn, going about my business. Oh, Diabolic Tutor. Alright. Well, that I cannot stop. Do I want to cast Disperse just for value here? What would I disperse? Nothing really worth dispersing. And let's hit. Oh, there we go. And do I want to cast anything else? I think I just pass. I could cast Scroll Thief, but I don't really care about the 3 damage here. And I'd rather Essence Scatter without having to use Disperse. Since again, I assume my opponent tuned for a creature of some kind. Might not be the case, so it looks like a Cursed Spirit is getting turned into a card, and I'm losing a life. That's fine with me. What would this Doomblade be had I sighted? Maybe like a Trained Condor or something? Interesting to note. Alright. Let's see what happens here. Yeah, that I will disperse, since I do kind of want this Phantom Warrior to win me the game here. I don't have a ton of paths to a quick victory, and I don't really want to play a long game against Dark Prophecy, so I think I'm happy doing that. 13. Hopefully I draw land next turn. That would be optimal. If I don't, I might just cast Divination. It's because I would like to keep Essence Scatter up if I can. Alright, I'm going to cast Divination. I think I got to go for it. If I don't hit a land, it's going to be really bad, though. Ugh. Well, at least now I know what to discard. Let's discard this Doomblade I stupidly didn't sideboard out, but now my opponent gets to resolve a spell this turn, and I didn't get to cast anything of relevance. That is very bad for me. Oh, didn't play anything. Interesting. Now this is tough, actually. If 4 cards in hand. I've got to assume no creatures. I'm just going to play the Water Servant. It's the most expensive card. Really would still rather draw land than anything else. But if my opponent had a creature, he would have played it last turn, so I think playing this is fine. I can just get Doombladed or whatever. This also sets up me playing a Nephalia Seakite at some point, and that would be pretty good. If I draw a land this turn, my opponent doesn't have a creature this turn, then I could be in really good shape. Uh-oh. Blood Baron, yeah, that's annoying. And that's not a land. Looking to see what I can Archaemancer back. I can play a Seakite. Blood Baron's doing a potential 6 to me here. I guess I can just play a Seakite because it costs the most. Alright. And I can't even pass. Alright, yeah. Not hitting my 5th land drop here has been just brutal. Since with 5 lands, I could leave Essence Scatter up while playing 3 drops, then I'd be in pretty good shape. With 4 lands, I can play 1 spell a turn, and it's not going to be quite enough. I'm already behind enough here. So I think I just block the Undead Minotaur. Take 3, go to 7. Opponent could sack the Minotaur here. Alright, that's reasonable. Take 4 going to 6, or 5 rather. Or take 5 going to 5, and then it's got a non-zombie in play and drew a card, which led to a Corrupt. Alright, well, as usual, early exit, since so far that has seemed to be the case.